2. Religious facts. The supporters of the Darko-Roman myth have a quite bizarre explanation of the conversion to Christianity of the early Romanians. They assert that they became Christian around the 4th or 5th century CE, while hidden in the caves in Transylvania. There are many inconsistencies in such theory. For example, who passed on to them the Christian message, and how did those hypothetic missionaries find them while the rulers, warriors and settlers did not know about their existence for 1,000 years? Would the conquerors neglect a potential slave working force? Could it be possible that not even one of the Goths, Gepids, Huns, Sarmatians, Avars, Slavs, Bulgars, Magyars or Cumans had ever found at least by chance one of the troglodytes? Nor any of the monks or whoever would have been going to the caves with the gospel has ever been discovered? Why the alleged caves have still not been identified, and not any religious object, relic, image or inscription has been found in any cave or catacomb, neither on walls nor on gravestones, as in every other place where Christianity, either openly or secretly, existed. There is not any Romanian church or writing or document of any kind in Transylvania previous to the 13th century CE. Why did these Christians remain hidden even after Transylvania was under Christian Bulgaria since the 9th century CE? Why did they stay in such conditions until 4 centuries later? After the discovery of a Latin-speaking Christian people by the church authorities, because if they became Christians there must have been somebody who was sent as missionary that reached them, Transylvania would have been regarded as an outpost of Christendom in barbaric lands, and churches and the monasteries would have been founded, mainly after the later 9th century CE. When the Bulgarian rulers would have favored such a promotion of Christianity within their domain. Why nothing of all this did happen? Would the Romanians still need to be hidden, while in Bulgaria they were free citizens and had the same religion? The liturgical language of the Romanian Church has never been Latin, but Old Slavonic until the later 19th century CE. Why would the proud descent of the Romans accept such a thing, when their own language was the official one of the Church? How could they have adopted the liturgy of a people that theoretically arrived, being still heathen, 1 century after the Romanians' own conversion, and how did they get in touch with those peoples being hidden in caves? Since the earliest available records concerning the religious membership of the Romanians, it is clear that they have always belonged to the Eastern Slavic Rites Church, that since 1054 CE is separated from Rome and belongs to the Orthodox Confession? Notice that Romanians are the only Latin-speaking people that is not traditionally Roman Catholic. In that period, the whole Transylvania was under the Hungarian crown. When the schism took place, Hungary remained with Rome and the king declared the Eastern Slavic Church illegal in all the territories of the Hungarian domain. Therefore, why did the alleged Darko-Romans join the Orthodox Church? And how did they manage not to be banished? Or else, who allowed them, as subjects of the Hungarian king, to follow a confession already declared illegal? There is only one possible explanation for all these mysteries: Romanians were not in Transylvania in those times. There are many other facts connected with the Romanians' religion that provide overwhelming proofs that their origin was in southern area and not in present-day Romania. It is evident that the whole of the Romanian people must have been dwelling in the Slavic territory that after 1054 CE separated from Rome, passing to the Orthodox Confession. Transylvania belonged entirely to the Roman Catholic area after the schism. Also, the Slavic peoples that adopted Latin alphabet, Croatians, Slovenians, Czech, Slovaks, Polish, remained with Rome. These facts limit the territory in which the Romanian people developed to the southern Balkan area, namely present-day Greece, Albania, Macedonia, Serbia and Bulgaria, that is south of the Lower Danube. Additional facts narrow such territory even more. When Byzantium annexed the Kingdom of Bulgaria, the emperor assigned all the Vlach people to the Archbishopric of Ohrida, that is in southern Albania, according to the original homeland of this people. Indeed, The whole Romanians were still under the Archdiocese of Ochrida until the 18th century CE. Even when other Orthodox Slavic rites bishoprics existed much nearer to Romania. Until the later 19th century CE. As the liturgical language was Old Slavonic, most of the priests and clergymen in Romania were Bulgarian or Serbian. These are clear evidences that show which the original land of the Romanian people was. The supporters of the Darko-Roman myth may argue that indeed there are also Roman Catholic Romanians, but we know with absolute certainty why and when they adopted such religion. The first group were the Cumans, that embraced the Roman Church in the 13th century CE. In Moldavia, then called Cumania. The second group were Romanians that, being Orthodox, were forced to accept the union with Rome in 1698 CE. By the Habsburg monarchy that ruled over Transylvania, under strong pressure through denial of civil rights to those that refused to convert. Those were the first Romanians that joined Rome in history of religion. To conclude this chapter, which has been exposed in a very concise manner, we can say that the religious heritage of Romanians reflects their ethnic origin and the mainly their geographic homeland until at least one century after the separation of European Christendom into Roman and Orthodox, division that was sharply defined by territory and that involved entire nations. The only Balkan peoples that belonged to the Orthodox Church and had Old Slavonic as liturgical language instead of Latin dwelled south of the Lower Danube until the later 12th century CE. 3. Linguistic facts. The Darko-Roman myth was framed mainly on the basis of Romanian language, which is classified in the Neo-Latin group. Such classification is correct. What is erroneous is the explanation given by the supporters of such theory concerning the reason by which it is a Neo-Latin tongue, and the place where it supposedly developed from Latin into modern Romanian. As most languages, it has also features that do not correspond with the general pattern shared by the other tongues of the same group, but belong to the substratum. Namely, the language spoken by the original population before they were Romanized, and other characteristics adopted from external influences in different historical periods. These features and the evolution of Latin into Romanian show in a definite manner the actual origin of the language and its geographic distribution according to historical stages. At present there are two main dialects of the Vlach language, Romanian and Aromanian, and both have also a sub-dialect. Austro-Romanian from the first one and Megaleno-Romanian from the second one. Aromanian and Megaleno-Romanian are still spoken in the original homeland of all Vlach peoples, Albania, Macedonia and Greece. While Austro-Romanian is represented by an exiguous number of speakers in Istria. Evidences prove that there was only one Vlach language until the 11th century CE. When the medieval ancestors of present-day Romanians began to get in touch with the peoples dwelling in the lands north of the Lower Danube and thus they progressively acquired loanwords from them, while Aromanian continued its development separately. Yet, both dialects are still understandable to each other. The characteristics of modern Romanian show that this language evolved in the southwest of the Balkan region since its very origins and during the centuries of Roman domination, that there was an intensive interaction with Albanian and a close relationship with the southern Italian dialect during that period, and that later it developed within the Bulgarian realm until the 11th century CE. On the other hand, there is a complete absence of old Germanic terms that must have been transferred into Romanian, at least in a minimum amount, during the centuries of Gothic Gepid rule, if Romanians were actually in Transylvania as the Darko-Roman myth supporters claim. There is also not any toponym in Transylvania having Romanian etymology before the 13th century CE. Nor any originally Romanian name for that region is recorded. Actually, the present and historic denomination, Ardeal/Transylvania, has been taken after Hungarian, Wadli. Indeed, the Romanian term, Ardeal, has no meaning, but is an adaptation of the old Magyar name Udo Elv, that means, land beyond the forest, translated into Latin as Transylvania. Such a name reflects the Hungarian viewpoint, as for Romanians that region should have been called Transcarpathia, the land beyond the Carpathian Mounts. Consequently, if Romanians were already there when Hungarians arrived, why then did they adopt the Magyar name? How could have they completely forgotten the denomination by which they knew the region before the arrival of RPD's hosts? In order to present in a comprehensible manner the linguistic aspects of Romanian that are relevant to the origin and evolution of the language, we will consider its relationship with Albanian, with Italian dialects and with Slavic separately. The Romanian-Albanian connection. A good amount of the non-Latin features present in Romanian language have their correspondence in Albanian, not only concerning lexicon but also structure, phraseology and idioms. These characteristics belong to two linguistic periods, the substratum, that is the language spoken by the Vlach before their Romanization, which may be the same of Albanian or a similar language, and the subsequent close contact between both peoples throughout a long period, mainly regarding their common lifestyle as shepherds. Since the controversy about the origin of Albanians is presented by two main theories, one proposing the Arian stem and the other the Thracian stem, the advocates of the Daco-Roman myth vehemently support the second possibility, as they cannot deny the strong links between the Vlach and the Albanian peoples in early times. It is not our task to discuss about the origin of Albanians here, and in any case it is irrelevant whether one or the other theory is the right one, because the whole complex of proofs point out in a definitive manner to the area of present-day Albania and surrounding territory as the birthplace of the early Romanians and not the eastern side of the Balkans. Even if the Albanians would not be autochthonous but coming from any other place, it is in the area they live today where both peoples met and not elsewhere. A further factor is that there is not any historical record attesting any hypothetic migration of Albanians from Dacia, and there is not any vestige of their presence in that land, while there are many documents proving that the Vlach people lived since the early centuries by the southern Adriatic coastland, even before the Roman occupation of Dacia. And as a matter of fact, there are still historic Romanian communities, Romanians, living there. Linguistic research has determined that most of the words shared by Romanian and Albanian are not loans from one tongue to the other but have a common origin in the substratum, before then these two languages began to be distinguished from each other. Romanian terms that are similar to Albanian mainly regard primary elements like body parts, names of animals and plants, and words specifically related with the pastoral life. It is significant that such vocabulary in Romanian is not found in Slavic or any other language spoken in the Balkans but only in Albanian. Another interesting fact concerns the very name of the capital city of Romania, București, a word that is similar to the Albanian term București, having the same meaning. While the Vlach people were thoroughly Latinized, Albanian language has also received the influence of Latin since early times. A common territory and lifestyle shared by both peoples have produced the same semantic changes in both languages. A considerable number of Latin terms have undergone identical changes of meaning without parallel in any other tongue, and they cannot have happened just by chance or by any logical reason except because both peoples were living in a common environment and in the same territory. Among the unusual features present in Romanian that are explainable by a comparison with Albanian, we find also the definite article, that in classic Latin precedes the noun but is enclitic in Romanian and follows the same patterns as in Albanian, and the personal pronoun in accusative case, that contains the suffix -ni, exactly like in Albanian. The Romanian-Italic relationship. If the Slavic, Hungarian and Albanian terms were removed from Romanian language, it would fully qualify as a southern Italian dialect. There are many structural, phonetic and idiomatic aspects that are amazingly similar between Romanian and Salentine-Apulian, Neapolitan, Calabrian and other tongues of southern Italy, and also some elements of the northeastern Italian dialects spoken by the Adriatic coastland. Today in Salento, the heel of Italy, we can hear that local people greet each other saying, "Si farsi?" That is exactly like in Romanian, or else in Sicily they leave each other saying, Ne vedem, which is also the same expression used in Romanian. If we are in Naples, perhaps we can by chance hear the phrase, Sorata, with the same literal meaning as in Romanian, or maybe that a young man would njura, pronounced like njura in Romanian and with the same meaning. These are only few examples from a long number of similar parallelisms. Such amount of expressions are not a coincidence but the result of an active interaction between the early ancestors of Romanians and southern Italians in the period previous to the arrival of the Slavic peoples in the Balkans, that is, before the 6th century CE. This evidence is not unknown by the Dark-Roman myth supporters, but purposely neglected. From all the common features that regard the Italic dialects on one side and Romanian on the other, it results evident that both groups have undergone the same evolution process since the early stage, when still classic Latin was spoken, until the arrival of the Slavs in the Balkans, for about 6 centuries of close contact and geographic proximity. Concerning the similarities between Salentine Apulian and Romanian, a possible link may be the ancient Mesopandiapygii, peoples that inhabited on both sides of the Adriatic Sea, though mainly in Italy. The origin of these peoples had still not been determined with certainty. Some scholars suggest that they were Iric tribes that sailed to the opposite shore and settled in the southeastern region of Italy, while others assign them a Mycenaean origin. It is not relevant where did they come from, but it is significant the fact that many toponyms and inscriptions left by the Messapae in Italy have a correspondence on the opposite shore of the Adriatic. They probably established colonies or trade centers in Iria or were in some way related with Iric peoples. We discard the possibility that the Vlach were Messapae because of their quite different lifestyles. The Vlach have been shepherds since old, while the Messapae were strenuous warriors. Notwithstanding, as the same language may be shared by completely different peoples and linguistics by itself alone is irrelevant to determine ethnic origins, it is however essential for establishing where a people sojourned and for how long. So, according to their common characteristics, we can assert that Vlach and Messapae have been neighbors and once they both have adopted Latin as their language, the tongues spoken by both peoples followed a similar evolution. The Greek influence over both southern Iria and southern Italy, called Magna Graecia, has affected Romanian as well as the Italic dialects in some aspects, like the replacement of the infinitive in composed verbal forms. It is noticeable that Italic and southern Balkan languages, as well as Romanian, behave according to a common pattern that is exclusive of them, which consists in replacing the infinitive with conjunctive. This feature is absent in central/northern Italian dialects. Another phenomenon concerning the infinitive that is verified in the same way in Romanian and Italic is the elision of the Latin ending re, for example, scientar, re, asculta, re, dormi, re, etc. Regarding the pronoun, the genitive used as dative was quite a rarity in classic Latin but became the rule within a geographically continuous area during the process of transition towards the Romance languages, a case that would not have been verified in Romanian if it was spoken in a separate region. It is from medieval Latin that we can explain, for instance, the use of lo, loro and lo in French, Italian and Romanian respectively, while the same pattern is not valid for the other Neo-Latin languages. The plural of the noun in modern Italian and Romanian is formed by replacing or adding an ending vowel i/tilde, while in all the other Romance languages consists in adding a final s to the singular form. When these two different patterns arose, they were sharply defined geographically, being the ending vowel the characteristic of the languages spoken from Tuscany southwards. There are still more features, morphologic and phonetic, which Romanian shares with southern Italian dialects, like the postposition of the possessive pronoun that is typical of Neapolitan dialect, which assumed the same structure as Romanian, or the frequent ending u for the male gender nouns. Romanian shares some linguistic characteristics also with Sardinian as well as with northeastern Italian dialects and with the unfortunately extinct Dalmatian language. It is relevant for our research to remark that there is hardly a Latin-derived word in Romanian related with administration, science, arts and crafts, and whatever belongs to normal activity of city dwellers. This fact is another evidence against the Darker Roman myth, because Roman occupants in Dacia were officials, legionaries and civilian settlers, not farmers or shepherds. Therefore, how is it possible that Romanian language has not inherited any of these words that belong to the essential Roman vocabulary in that period? Even non-Latin languages have at least few Latin-derived terms concerning this aspect. As a matter of fact, such words in Romanian have not a Germanic origin either, which leads us inexorably to the conclusion that Romanians were not in the Carpathian Basin during the centuries of Gothic Gepid rule. The Romanian word for city is oraș, whose Magyar origin, viroș, suggests that they began to dwell in urban centers only when they got in touch with the Hungarian realm. Namely, when the medieval Romanians, then known as Vlach, were offered asylum in Transylvania by the Hungarian monarchs when the Turks seized Wallachia. Romanian language shows overwhelming evidence to have followed the whole evolution of Latin spoken in the southwestern half of the Balkans, that belonged to the Eastern Roman Empire until the Slavic invasions in the 7th century CE, period in which the ancestors of modern Romanians, namely, the Vlach, had an intensive contact with the peoples living in southern Italy and by the Adriatic coastlands. The Slavic influence. Romanian language has received a relevant contribution from southern Slavic, even though such influence has been artificially reduced in the later 19th century CE by the so-called re-Latinization of Romanian. Actually, it must be properly referred to as Latinization, because it was not a return to a previous situation but the introduction of new foreign elements to reform the language. It was also within this process that the former national name was changed from Vlach to Romen. The original Romanian alphabet, that was Cyrillic until 1868 CE, was replaced by the Latin alphabet, to which some additional characters, not existing in any other Neo-Latin language, were added in order to represent the phonemic elements that previously were satisfactorily supplied by the Cyrillic characters. Through this process of Latinization, the percentage of Slavic terms in Romanian had been halved. Nevertheless, there are still many Slavic words and other linguistic features that attest the long sojourn of the Vlach/Romanians in the Slavic territories south of the Lower Danube, mainly in Bulgaria. One of the features of Slavic origin that has been widely exploited in favor of the Darker Roman myth regards a Roman character that was adopted by southern Slavs since they settled in the Balkans, that is Trajan, the conqueror of Dacia. Several Roman constructions in Iria, roads, towers, gates, garrisons, were either built by that emperor or ascribed to him. Toponyms that the Slavs have conserved as a standard designation of any Roman structure, under the Slavic forms Trojanj, Trojanov, Trojansky, etc. The name of the Roman emperor became legendary among southern Slavs, a character that was transferred to their Vlach neighbors and that would have been used many centuries later by the supporters of Romanian extremist nationalism. There was only one Vlach language until the 11th century CE. It is in that epoch that the earliest differences between present-day Romanian and Romanian began to arise, as the Vlach people expanded over a vast area from the original homeland by the Adriatic Sea throughout the Bulgarian kingdom, and subsequently numerous Vlach settled in Cumania, north of the Lower Danube, then renamed Wallachia. Since that period, the influence of Bulgarian was stronger on the Romanian branch than on the Romanian one. However, well-documented sources attest that until the 13th century CE, there were still Vlach people of the northern group living in Kosovo, and some of their names are mentioned in an account written by Stefan Prvovinkani Nemanja, king of Serbia. What is interesting is that those names do not belong to the Romanian branch because they contain a pattern that is exclusive of the Romanian language spoken in the north. It is in fact when the whole Vlach people were living within the borders of the Bulgarian kingdom that they acquired the words regarding social and political organization, 7th-8th centuries CE. And ecclesiastic order, 9th century CE. As well as the first alphabet. Cyrillic. Romanian, indeed, was not a written language but only spoken until that time, being the bulk of the Vlach population transhuman shepherds and not town dwellers. Of course, if they would have been descendants of Roman soldiers and settlers, they would have already had a written language with Latin characters. The religious vocabulary in Romanian language shows in a clear manner that the Vlach people were educated within the Bulgarian Orthodox Church, a fact that would be unexplainable if Romanians would have been outside the borders of the Bulgarian realm before the schism, 1054 CE. Or immediately after, as the terminology that is properly Orthodox should have needed some years to be consolidated as different from the one of the earlier common church. This evidence implies that Romanians were closely related with Bulgaria at least until the 12th century CE. Among the extensive Slavic lexicon present in Romanian language, there are most of the words related with human feelings and relationship, terms like love, dear, bride, wife, betrothed, etc. are all of Slavic origin. Many words that belong to everybody's essential vocabulary are Slavic, including every time that a Romanian says yes, da. Furthermore, Slavic has heavily influenced on Romanian pronunciation and cadence, for example in the artification of the vowel e, that in Romanian is often pronounced ye, which is a typical feature of Slavic languages. The Slavic influence on Romanian was clearly exerted by southern Slavs, namely, the branch that founded the historic kingdoms of Bulgaria and Serbia, after centuries of coexistence in the same territory. Contrary to the Dark-Roman myth, the Slavs that dwelled in Transylvania were not the southern but the western Slavs, to which belong Czech, Slovaks, Slovens and Poles, and later the Slavicized Croats, and their impact in Transylvania has never been so strong as they were not the rulers of that land but subject to the Avar Ring. Furthermore, none of the western Slavs adopted Cyrillic alphabet, and they did not join the Orthodox Church but remained under the Roman Catholic one. Consequently, if the Dark-Roman myth was true, today Romanians would not be Orthodox but Roman Catholic, they would have always had a Latin alphabet and their Slavic words would not be of Bulgarian-Serbian background but rather Slovenian-Slovak terms. Conclusion: history records and scientific research on the people and their culture, their language and their religious tradition show the truth about Romanian origins. Unfortunately, an artificial and untenable theory has been deeply embedded on that people to the detriment of truth and honesty by fanatic nationalist leaders. The knowledge of the truth will not cause their expulsion from the land where they live, on the contrary, will grant them the freedom that they have never had.